and the one on the right of me stuck her tongue in my ear.
The weirdest job I've ever had.
Damn. Oh my God.
I found out that my coworker was writing an erotic novel starring me.
We're doing a bit of charity fundraising.
I worked at a school uniform store. It's like during back to school, so you get prepared for back to school.
It was me and my partner, Theo Fox. He gave me his permission to use his name. We were knocking on doors and this old lady opened. You know, you gave the spiel, there's this many people with cancer. It's really important that we have the services to support people like. And she went, oh yeah, that's great, come in. Which is obviously unusual because 99% of the time it's rejection. It reeks of jazz cigarettes and there were ashtrays and cans everywhere. Well, past the corridor to get in, there was like a sort of, I think it would be fair to call it a shrine to all dead family members and that. And we walked into the main room and there was a sofa and an armchair. Theo sat down in the armchair, I sat down on the sofa. They sat, one sat either side of me. And you know, they were sort of petting me a bit, showing just enough interest so that I would stay there in order to maybe get them to sign something. Anyway, Theo, my friend, I saw him go onto his settings page on his phone and pick out a ringtone and go, so I've got a call. Meet you outside, Arthur, like that. So he left me in there with these two old ladies, one either side of me. And the one on the left of me was talking vaguely about how she might want to contribute to Macmillan Cancer Support. And the one on the right of me stuck her tongue in my ear, like that. The other one got up and locked the door. It was just a bit of a giggle, really. I said, look, I'm really not into this. And I left, I stepped out into the daylight.
My coworker, I found out that my coworker was writing an erotic novel starring me and another coworker. And the way that I found out was he used to write it at work. He never worked. He just used to hide in different places and write it. Like, you could see him writing it. He did it everywhere. But his handwriting is so illegible that he used to take pride in it and say it was like his own secret language. But your girl decoded it. I was not happy. I found out how disturbing it was. I found out the main character was the other guy. And then I found out that he was using like descriptions of me, a light blue denim jacket, like those descriptions and stuff. And I remember the day he told everyone that he had an idea for a novel and then started writing it. And he would like write it and stare at me and then look down. Oh, yeah.
So weird.
Yeah, because it was a temp job over the summer. Like, my contract was gonna end, I was gonna get out, and like, it was gonna be fine. So I just like held it in. I didn't want him to find out while I was at work because I was so freaked out. And like, on my final day, it was our final day because his contract ended the same day. He tried to hug me, and I remember I dropped my phone on purpose and then dropped everything else on the floor and went, oh, just high five. And I like slapped his hand away, even though he wanted a hand shake. And I was like, that actually happened.
I've hosted a party once for little kids and a nightmare. They were screaming, shouting, crying, laughing. I don't know, it felt really weird for me. I'll just hang out with like people my age group. I just had to monitor the kids and make sure they were all okay. It was just chaos. Chaos for me. Yeah. All sorts. And then they have like lunch at a certain time.
A waitering. Like, you'd see like waiters. Like, they would go around drinking alcohol or like eating the food. Clients themselves, they would be drunk and like you'd have to manage it yourself. Or like you wouldn't know how to react to them. Them not knowing that they're drunk and then people telling them that they are and then like a group of them just fighting about for no reason.
So for shop, you know how they always have sales on? So they employ like, I don't know, like five or six kind of sales assistants who don't actually know anything about sofas. They just make like tea and coffee for like the customers that come in. And when you open the doors at 9 a.m, there are people literally fighting each other to get in. And it's like, oh my gosh, it's a sofa, chill, like.
So I was working at a call center.
I worked at a cricket ground for a bit.
I had like a Scottish lady on the phone because we were doing outbound calls.
I was behind the bar.
And she took the piss, she knew what the fuck she was doing. She just started to have phone sex with me.
I see bare corporate meetings being done like at cricket events, which is hilarious. Like, so families go to watch cricket, like old people, just a mishmash, but everyone's getting pissed, drunk. Except for the kids, obviously. But yeah, that was it. I think that's the weirdest place I've worked.
I'm at work and I have to stay on the phone for a while. The KPIs are like how long you're on the call, right? So I'm on this call for like about a good 5 minutes and she's literally saying, oh, I'm taking them off in like some thick Scottish accent. And I'm just like, yeah. She's like, what are you wearing? And I'm like, oh, I'm wearing my uniform. She's like, oh, that's nice. What color's your tie? And I'm like, it's black. And it was just like disgusting. And I could tell she was old. Like her name was like Agnes or Dorothy or some shit. Like you don't name a 30-year-old Dorothy. I don't know.
That's a good story.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
As I left at work, I went straight to Tesco's and bought myself like whiskey and then drank my way home.